عباده الذين اصطفى. أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. وإذا أذقنا الناس رحمة من بعد ضراء مستهم إذا لهم مكر في آياتنا قل الله أسرع مكرا إن رسلنا يكتبون ما تمكرون. هو الذي يسيركم في البر والبحر حتى إذا كنتم في الفلك وجرين بهم بريح طيبة وفرحوا بها جاءتها ريح عاصف وجاءهم الموج من كل مكان وظنوا أنهم أحيط بهم دعوا الله مخلصين له الدين لئن أنجيتنا من هذه لنكونن من الشاكرين. فلما أنجاهم إذا هم يبغون في الأرض بغير الحق يا أيها الناس إنما بغيكم على أنفسكم متاع الحياة الدنيا ثم إلينا مرجعكم فننبئكم بما كنتم تعملون. صدق الله العظيم وبلغنا رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين. سورة يونس. Today, inshallah, we are starting from the 21st ayah. وَإِذَا أَذَقْنَا النَّاسَ رَحْمَةً مِّن بَعْدِ ضَرَّاءَ مَسَّتْهُمْ إِذَا لَهُمْ مَكْرٌ فِي آيَاتِنَا قُلِ اللَّهُ أَسْرَعُ مَكْرًا إِنَّ رُسُلَنَا يَكْتُبُونَ مَا تَمْكُرُونَ. So the ayah says that if a people is afflicted with hardship, they are going through a hard time of whatever sort, and then we let them taste our mercy. So we take away that pain and suffering and let them taste our mercy and give them plenty and abundance and comfort after a hardship would have afflicted them. They at once start doing makrun fi ayatina. They start doing mischief, and makr means making plans and making plans to harm. So they start doing that in our signs against our verses. قُلِ اللَّهُ أَسْرَعُ مَكْرًا. Say Allah is quicker, swifter in implementing His plan. So makr is planning. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that the plans that you are making to belie, give a lie to our signs and to oppose them, tell them that Allah is quicker, swifter in His plans and implementing His plans. إِنَّ رُسُلَنَا يَكْتُبُونَ مَا تَمْكُرُونَ. Whatever you are doing, إِنَّ رُسُلَنَا, our messengers, which means our angels. So Rusul literally means somebody who's been sent. So the angels are also, this word is also used sometimes for angels, that Rusulana, our messengers or our angels. They are writing it. Yaktubuna ma tamkurun. They are writing what you are devising, what you are doing. They are, your whatever you are doing, they are writing it down. So they are also becoming a witness. Your book of deeds is also becoming a witness, apart from, of course, Allah's knowledge, perfect knowledge, being a witness against you. هُوَ الَّذِي يُسَيِّرُكُمْ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ حَتَّى إِذَا كُنْتُمْ فِي الْفُلْكِ وَجَرَيْنَ بِهِمْ بِرِيحٍ طَيِّبَةٍ وَفَرِحُوا بِهَا جَاءَتْهَا رِيحٌ عَاصِفٌ وَجَاءَهُمُ الْمَوْجُ مِنْ كُلِّ مَكَانٍ وَظَنُّوا أَنَّهُ أُحِيطَ بِهِمْ. He is the one who enables you to travel on land and sea. So this traveling on land and sea, the Arab people were also able to understand that how their economy and their survival depends on this travel, and Allah is the one who has enabled them to do it on land and at sea. That the trade that occurs, it occurs through their land routes and the sea routes. So Allah is the one who lets you do it. Hatta idha kuntum fil fulki, until when you are aboard the boats. So you board your boats. وَجَرَيْنَ بِهِمْ بِرِيحٍ طَيِّبَةٍ, and they sail with those on board, بِرِيحٍ طَيِّبَةٍ, under a favorable, pleasant wind. وَفَرِحُوا بِهَا, and you are pleased with, they are pleased with it. جَاءَتْهَا رِيحٌ عَاصِفٌ, then comes a violent wind. وَجَاءَهُمُ الْمَوْجُ, and the wave comes upon them. Min kulli makan, from all sides, from all directions. وَظَنُّوا أَنَّهُ أُحِيطَ بِهِمْ, and you think, they think that they are now surrounded from all sides. دَعَوُ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. They forget everything, all their idols, all those partners that they associate with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and دَعَوُ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ, very sincerely in Allah, having faith in Allah alone, they call after Allah, they ask Allah, لَئِنْ أَنْجَيْتَنَا مِنْ هَذِهِ لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الشَّاكِرِينَ. If only you give us freedom or deliver us from this problem, from this, لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الشَّاكِرِينَ, will become very good people. We will be grateful. فَلَمَّا أَنْجَاهُمْ, but when Allah does give them nijat, when Allah does deliver them from it, إِذَا هُمْ يَبْغُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ, they start rebellion in the earth without having any right. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ إِنَّمَا بَغْيُكُمْ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِكُمْ. O people, know that your rebellion is in fact only against your own selves. So whatever you're doing, going against the path, the command of Allah, being rebellious to Allah, it is going to not harm Allah, it's not going to harm the Muslims, it's not going to harm the Rasul of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but it is only going to harm you yourself, and you'll soon find it. مَتَاعَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا, it is only the worldly life that you are enjoying. ثُمَّ إِلَيْنَا مَرْجِعُكُمْ, then you are going to return to us. فَنُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ, and we'll tell you what you have been doing. إنما مثل الحياة الدنيا كما إن أنزلنا من السماء فاختلط به نبات الأرض مما يأكل الناس والأنعام. Another example Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving, the example of worldly life is just like the water we send down from the sky, then the vegetation of the earth grows forth with it, which is meant to be eaten by men and cattle. حتى until إذا أخذت الأرض زخرفها وزينت, and it happens so much that the earth takes its ornament or becomes beautiful, pleasant to look at, and is fully adorned, fully decorated. وَزَّيَّنَتْ وَظَنَّ أَهْلُهَا أَنَّهُمْ قَادِرُونَ عَلَيْهَا, and the people who have, you know, planted this, and they are waiting and they are thinking that we are fully in control of this and we are going to reap the benefits of it. أَتَاهَا أَمْرُنَا لَيْلًا أَوْ نَهَارًا, our command comes, and by day or by night or by day, our ataha amruna, our command came by night or by day. Faj'alnaha hasidan ka'an lam taghna bil ams, we turned it into stubble. Stubble is that which basically useless, totally useless dead vegetation. As if it had not been there a day earlier, totally disappears. كَذَٰلِكَ نُفَصِّلُ الْآيَاتِ لِقَوْمِ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elaborates the verses of himself, his verses, for a people who reflect. وَاللَّهُ يَدْعُو إِلَىٰ دَارِ السَّلَامِ, so this is the way of this world, that the troubles, they come, you call after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah gives you happiness and pleasure, and you, na'uzu billah, the way of your way is that you forget about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but nothing is permanent here, nothing is permanent. But Allah, what Allah calls you towards, وَاللَّهُ يَدْعُو إِلَىٰ دَارِ السَّلَامِ, Allah calls you towards دَارِ السَّلَامِ, a house of permanence, a house of permanent peace. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls you towards it by bringing faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are being called towards a much better, much higher, much supreme thing, which is دَارِ السَّلَامِ, the world of the hereafter. In Jannah, if you earn it, if you have iman and therefore become deserving of Jannah, then Allah is going to enter into Dar es Salaam. This dunya is Dar el Amal, that you constantly keep on having to, you have to struggle, you have to work hard. Sometimes the outcome will be favorable, sometimes the outcome will not be favorable. Sometimes there will be hardship, sometimes there will be good times. But what you have to do is that you have to keep on staying a faithful believer. And when you do that, then Allah enters you into Dar es Salaam, which is a abode of permanent peace. وَيَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ إِلَىٰ صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ, and it is Allah who guides those who wish, whom he wishes towards the right path. And who does Allah wish to guide to the right path? Those who try and present themselves. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us those who are guided to the right path and who enter Jannah with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam peacefully and without hisab. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka antas samiul alim wa tub alayna innaka antat tawwabur rahim. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala khayri khalqihi sayyidina wa maulana Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen.